Stroop Waffles of the Luftwaffe, Sundays on PBS. And now...
Smells like shoes. My guests today are the father and son comedy team of Leonard Tramiel, the disappointment to his father, and the overbearing parent himself, Mr. Jack Tramiel.
I understand that you're really famous on the vaudeville circuit, Jack. Could you give us a little taste of your act? A little joke? Something to help sell the tickets to the kids?
A TRS-80 color computer, a Commodore 64, and an Apple II walk into a bar. And the bartender looks around the room and says to them,
Okay, that's not really even a joke there, Jack. That's just the beginning of a joke, and then you laughed at it. But who cares? Let's talk about this thing now. Is this how you use it? Putting your hand right here? Or is it something like, you know, using it with a keyboard and mouse like a traditional computer? You would use something like that?
Yes, well, now you're trying to be funny, and it's not working. I'm the comedian, but let's talk about computers and chips and things like that. I am the master of the chips. So if you have a company and you want to buy microchips so you can make a computer, well, then you can't do it. And that's because I have all the chips. I will sell them to you, but not at a good price. You know what I mean? I will sell it to you for a bad price. And I will keep the good price for myself.
What do you mean you'd keep the good price for yourself? Why don't you just make it free for yourself since you own the chips?
You know, that's a good idea. I've never thought about it that way, but since you mention it, I think that's what I'll do. I will give myself the chips for free because I control the chips. All of the chips are mine. Do you know where they are? You don't know where they are. Do you, Gary?
You control the factory that makes the chips. I would assume that the chips would be at that factory, wouldn't they?
You would think that, but I can tell you that it's not true.
Well, Jack, it doesn't matter where the chips are physically. It only matters that you are the master of the chips.
The master of the chips!
Okay, Jack, let's not really just talk about where the chips are, because it really doesn't matter in the slightest.
But surely you want to know where the chips are, and I'm not going to tell you where they are. You couldn't drag it out of me where the chips are right now. But do you want me to tell you? I'll tell you. They're somewhere special, somewhere very special.
We don't care where they are. We'd like to talk, you know, more about the business, and we didn't ask you where the chips were. You don't have to tell us.
The chips are in an undisclosed location that's sort of low and in the back of me. Do you know what I mean? I put them up there myself, you know. You wouldn't believe the power, the computing power of my poopy hole right now. Ask it a question. Ask it anything. Any computation. Any computational math problem.
Okay, Jack, this is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard, but I'm just going to humor you. So, here's a problem. TRS-80 color computer, a Commodore 64, and an Apple II walk into a bar. How much is the bar tab for those three computer systems? How much do they have to pay as they leave the bar?
Oh, that's a tough one. Okay, let's see. Beep, 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 beep. It's thinking. Okay, beep, 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 beep. Yes, it has an answer for you, but I'm going to need a toilet and some paper. That's the delivery system, you know, for the answers, for this. Beep, beep, beep. No, wait, it was wrong. It was absolutely wrong. These chips are defective. Let's get them out of me. Okay, let's...
Speaking of getting things out of you rectally, let's talk to Leonard here. Leonard, can you give us a demo of this computer that you guys made there?
Okay, so this is our productivity software here, our productivity package that comes with every computer. Now, let's say you're a businessman and you're just sitting in your office staring at the wall because you really have no idea what your job is. You know, and then your boss comes in. He's all sweaty. It's a big urgent thing. And he says, "Hey, Sally, I need you to resize a window for me." So you resize a window. And he says, "That's great, Sally. Your name's not Sally, by the way." Then he says, "Hey, Sally, I need you to click on something." So you click on it. You know, anything your boss really comes in and wants you to do, you click on something else. This really has all the features of any productivity package that any business could really want. I'm moving a window right now. All this stuff that, you know, they do at business.
You know, if I was your boss right now, I'd fire you. You're fired. Get out. Clean your desk out. I'm calling security. You're not allowed back in this building ever again. That was the worst software.
Ah, you know, come on. I'm just trying to get ahead here. I'm working 80-hour weeks, and I got kids to feed.
Hey, I'll pretend to be your wife now that you got fired and you just told me that you were fired. Oh, honey. Oh, God, I'm divorcing you. I'm leaving you.
This is all fun and everything, but do you want me to tell you what I was doing while you were pretending to be my son's wife, my no-good son?
Don't you talk about my husband that way. He may not be very good in bed at all, but he's all I've got and we have two beautiful children together. You can't take that away from us. Nobody can.
Okay, that's it. You're out of the will. Nothing for you. Nothing for my no-good son. Nothing for my grandkids. But son, let me tell you, did you know that your wife and I are having an affair? You know, when you work those 80-hour weeks? And now that I've exposed our illicit affair, I would like everyone to know that those microchips, those defective microchips, they're not in me anymore. They're out of me now. But don't worry about how I got them out of me. They're not in there, and that's all you need to know. I'll just tell you that they didn't come out the same way they went in.
I think you're hiding something else up there, aren't you, Jack?
Let's change the subject. A TRS-80 color computer, Commodore 64, and an Apple II walk into a bar, you know. And the bartender says to them, he looks around and he says to them, "It looks like you have something, you know, up there in the low part of behind you." The TRS-80 color computer looks at the bartender and says, "I have back there, I have bits, the Apple II." He looks at the bartender. He says, "I have bytes." The Commodore 64 looks at the bartender and he says, "I have butts." That's the joke. Bits, bites, and butts. Oh, yes, it's a good one.
Mm-hmm.